Good morning, students. So last class we discuss about the transmission line terminated with inductive reactants and inductive capacitors, and also T junction and concept of Lewis lattice diagram. Now we go for the numerical problems on transient systems with different applications. So numerical problems. Subject is electrical power transmission system. Third BTech, first sem, R15. So the numerical problems on termination of lines with different type of condition, that is traveling wave with open ended line and short circuit line. So for the two cases, we have to calculate the reflection constant, reflection voltage, reflection current, as well as refraction voltage, refraction current, right? Go through the problem. A cable has a conductor of radius 0.75 centimeter and a sheath of inner radius 2.5 centimeter. Find the inductance per meter length. Second one, capacitance per meter length. Third one, surge impedance. And fourth one, velocity of propagation. If the permittivity of insulation is 4, right? So first of all, go through the problem. The cable has a conductor of radius 0.5 centimeter, that is radius of the conductor small r is equal to 0.75 centimeter, and sheath inner radius capital R is equal to 2.5 centimeter. Permittivity epsilon R equal to 4. Therefore, first inductance per meter length, L is equal to 2 × 10⁻⁷ ln D by capital R by small r, Henry per meter. Therefore, 2 × 10⁻⁷ ln 2.5 by 0.75, that is equal to inductance L is equal to 2.41 × 10⁻⁷ Henry per meter. Second one, capacitance. C is equal to 2 pi epsilon by ln capital R by small r farad per meter. And we know that epsilon is equal to epsilon naught epsilon r. So C is equal to 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon r divided by ln capital R by small r farad per meter, that is equal to 4 × 10⁻⁹ / 18 ln capital R by small r farad per meter. So after substituting the epsilon naught epsilon r, all the values, so we are getting 4 × 10⁻⁹ / 18 × ln capital R 2.5 by smaller 0.75, that is equal to C is equal to 0.1846 × 10⁻⁹ farad per meter. Now calculate the surge impedance ZC. ZC is equal to, we know that form, empirical formula, ZC equal to root L by C already. So we have to calculate the inductance L, and we have also calculated capacitance C. Therefore, substitute L and C values in the above equation. ZC, characteristic impedance or surge impedance, equal to root L by C, that is equal to 2.41 × 10⁻⁷ / 0.1846 × 10⁻⁹. So that is equal to surge impedance ZC equal to 36.13 ohms. Similarly, fourth one, they calculating velocity of propagation. We already derived the formula. Velocity of wave propagation equal to 1 / √LC, that is equal to the velocity of light, that is 3 × 10⁸, we have derived already, but here the values are different for L and C. Therefore, V is equal to 1 / √LC, that is equal to V equal to 1 by root 2.41 into 10 power minus 7 multiplied by 0.1846 into 10 power minus 9. So therefore, velocity of wave propagation v is equal to 1.5 into 10 power 8 meters per second. Like that, we have to calculate the all the values. Here first we have to calculate the inductance, then calculate the capacitance, after then surge impedance, then velocity of wave propagation. How to remember the formulas? L is equal to 2 into 10 power minus 7 ln capital R by small r, otherwise d by r. So C is equal to 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon r by ln r by r. Surge impedance Zc is equal to root L by C, and the velocity of wave propagation is equal to v, small v is equal to 1 by root Lc. Like that we have to calculate the all these things. Go through the another problem. It is ended with a cable problem. An overhead line with inductance and capacitance for kilometer length of 1.3 millihenry and 0.09 microfarad respectively is connected in series with an underground cable having inductance and capacitance of 0.2 millihenry per kilometer and 0.3 microfarad per kilometer respectively. Now calculate the value of reflected and refracted waves of voltage and current at the junctions due to a voltage surge of 100 kV traveling to the junction 1 along the line towards the cable, 2 along the cable towards the line. We know that transmission line surge impedance ZL is equal to root L by C. Given data, the given transmission line inductance capacitance, that is 1.3 millihenry, C is equal to 0.09 microfarad. And similarly, the given cable inductor and capacitor 0.2 millihenry per kilometer, 0.3 microfarad per kilometer. Okay, so first we have to calculate the impedance for transmission line. ZL is equal to root L by C, that is equal to root 1.3 into 10 power minus 3 by 0.09 into 10 power minus 6, that is equal to 120.18 ohms. ZC is equal to root L by C, that is equal to root 0.2 into 10 power minus 3 by 0.3 into 10 power minus 6, that is equal to 25.82 ohms. So this is the transmission line surge impedance, cable line surge impedance. Now we have to calculate the first one, voltage wave magnitude of 100 kV which is inserted at the overhead line. So calculate the reflected voltage, refracted voltage, reflected current, refracted current, where voltage wave magnitude of 100 kV which is inserted at the overhead lines. Second one, cable. So reflected voltage V is equal to 2ZC V dash by ZC plus ZL. We know the all the values, 2 into ZC 25.82 into V dash 100 divided by 25.82 plus 120.18. Then we are getting V is equal to 35.37 volt kV kilovolts. Next, transmitted voltage V double dash ZC minus ZL by ZC plus ZL into V dash ZC, cable impedance 25.82 minus transmission line impedance 120.18 by 25.8 plus 120.18 into 100. V dash is 100, therefore we are getting transmitted voltage is minus 64.63 kV. Similarly, reflected current I is equal to I dash into 2 ZL by ZC dash plus ZL. So we know that I dash is nothing but V dash by ZL into 2 ZL by ZC plus ZL. V dash is 100 by ZL 120.18 multiplied by 2 into 120.18 by 25.82 plus 120.18. Then you can calculate the with the help of calculator. So I is equal to 1.37 kilo amperes. Similarly, transmitted current or refracted current I double dash is equal to V double dash by ZL. We know the V double dash minus 64.63 divided by ZL. What is the ZL value? 120.188. That is equal to I double dash is equal to minus 537.74 amperes. This is the voltage wave of magnitude 100 kV and which is initiated in the incident wave or transmission line. Now same will be calculated in the cable. Voltage wave magnitude of 100 kV which is incited in underground cable is partially reflected and partially transmitted on that overhead transmission line at the junction of the cable. Therefore, transmitted voltage V is equal to 2 ZL V dash by 2 ZL plus ZC 2 into 120.18 into 100 divided by 120.18 plus 25.82. It is equal to 164.63 kV. Reflected voltage V double dash is equal to ZL minus ZC by ZL plus ZC into V dash 120 minus 18 minus 25.82 divided by 120 minus 18 plus 25.82 into 100, that is equal to 64.63 kV. Similarly, transmitted current I is equal to I dash into 2 ZC by ZL plus ZC. So these are all formulas already we have derived in the last classes. So we have to identify, we have to remember all these formulas and we can calculate for problem is very, very easy. Therefore, transmitted current I is equal to I dash into 2 ZC by ZL plus ZC. But we know that I dash is equal to V dash by ZC. That is 100 by 25.82 multiplied by 2 into ZC is nothing but 25.82 divided by ZL 120.18 plus 25.82. So that is equal to transmitted current I is equal to 1.37 kiloamperes. Now reflected current I double dash is equal to V double dash by ZC. 64.63 minus 64.63 divided by 25.82, that is equal to minus 2.503 kiloamperes. Like that, we have to calculate the transmitted voltage, the reflected voltage, transmitted current and reflected current at the cable side. We have to calculate transmission line side, we have to calculate cable side, right? So another problem, this is also similar to the last problem. Transmission line and cable both are connected with a impedances of ZL and ZC, right? Two stations are connected together by an underground cable having a surge impedance of 50 ohms joined to an overhead line with a surge impedance of 400 ohms. If a surge having a maximum value of 110 kV travels along the cable towards the junction with the overhead line, determine the value of reflected and transmitted wave of voltage and current at the junction. Similar problem, but they don't given inductance capacitance for transmission line, they don't given inductance capacitance for cable, they directly given ZL and ZC. Always cable synchronous, surge impedance is less than the overhead line, overhead transmission lines. Therefore, surge impedance of the cable ZC is equal to 50 ohms, surge impedance of the transmission line ZL is equal to 400 ohms. The voltage wave with a magnitude of 110 kV initiated in the cable is partially reflected and partially transmitted. Therefore, transmitted voltage V is equal to 2 ZL V dash by ZL plus ZC. 2 ZL V dash by ZL plus ZC. 2 into 400 into 110 divided by 400 plus 50, that is equal to 195.56 kV. Similarly, reflected voltage V double dash is equal to ZL minus ZC by ZL plus ZC into V dash 400 minus 50 by 400 plus 50 into 110. So reflected voltage V double dash is equal to 85.56 kV. Transmitted current I is equal to I dash into 2 ZC by ZL plus ZC. So I dash is equal to V dash by Z naught, that is 110 by 50 into 2 into ZC, 50 by 400 plus 50, that is equal to 488.4 89 amperes. Another one, reflected current I double dash is equal to minus V double dash by ZC minus 85.56 divided by 50, that is equal to I double dash is equal to minus 1711.2 amperes. Like that, you have to calculate the reflected voltage, transmitted voltage, reflected current, transmitted current. The ends of two long transmission lines A and C are connected by a cable capital B of length 1 kilometer. The surge impedances of capital A, B and C are 450, 500 ohms respectively. A rectangular voltage wave of 25 kV magnitude and of infinite length is initiated in capital A and travels to capital C. Determine the first and second voltages impressed on C. So that is nothing but V2 and V4. First we have to initiate it with 20 kV and it will be initiated and it will be traveling, right? So V2 is equal to 2ZB V dash by ZA plus ZB, 2 into 50 into 25 by 400 by plus 50, 5.46 kV. And V4, so V2 is nothing but reflected wave and V4 is nothing but transmitted wave, that is refracted. 2ZC V2 by ZB plus ZC, 2 into 500 into 5.56 divided by 50 plus 500, that is 10.11 kV. Now we have to calculate the reflected voltage, that is V3, ZC minus ZB. So reflected wave, that is nothing but this is the C and this is the B, that's why ZC minus ZB by ZC plus ZB into V2. So this is the V2 is the initiated for V3. That's why V3 is equal to ZC minus ZB by ZC plus ZB into V2. 500 minus 50 by 500 plus 50 into 5.56. Calculating this calculator. So V3 is equal to 4.55 kV. Next V5. V5 is utilizing the V3 and it is in between ZB and ZA, right? ZB and ZA, that's why V5 is equal to ZA minus ZB by ZA plus ZB into V3. So that is equal to 400 minus 50 by 400 plus 50 into 4.55, that is equal to 3.54 kV. Now V6 is the because of V5. And it is not reflected again, that's why 2ZC V5 by ZB plus ZC, 2 into 500 into 3.54 by 50 plus 500, that is equal to 6.44 kV. Second immersed voltage is nothing but V4 plus V6. Second side immersed voltages, that is V4 and V6. V4 is 4.55 kV plus V6 is 6.44 kV, therefore, so V4 is nothing but 10.11 plus 6.44, that is 16.55 kV. V4 is nothing but all these things, V3, V2, like that. A cable has a conductor of radius 0.75 centimeter and a sheath inner radius of 2.5 cm. Find the inductance for meter length, capacitance for meter length, surge impedance, velocity of propagation if the permittivity of insulation is 4. I think this problem is already doing, but values are different. I think permittivity is same 4, but small r 0.75 and capital R 2.7. So we know the formulas. Inductance for meter length of the cable, L is equal to 2 into 10 power minus 7 ln capital R by small r Henry per meter, that is 2 into 10 power minus 7 ln 2.5 by 0.75, that is equal to, so L is equal to 2.41 into 10 power minus 7 Henry per meter. Second one, capacitance for meter length of a cable is C is equal to 2 pi epsilon naught epsilon r divided by ln capital R by small r farad per meter. So the value is 4 into 10 power minus 9 divided by 18 into ln 2.55 by 0.75. Therefore, C is equal to 0.1846 into 10 power minus 9 farad per meter. And the third one is surge impedance, that is equal to root L by C, root 2.41 into 10 power minus 7 divided by 0.1846 into 10 power minus 9. So ZC is equal to 36.13 ohms. And last one is velocity of wave propagation, V is equal to 1 by root LC, that is equal to 1 by root 2.41 into 10 power minus 7 multiplied by 0.1846 into 10 power minus 9. Therefore, velocity of wave propagation is, for a given problem, is 1.5 into 10 power 8 meters per second. A rectangular wave travels along a 500 kilometers line terminated with resistance of 1000 ohm. The line has a resistance of 0.3 ohm per kilometer, surge impedance of 400 ohms. If the voltage at the transmission point after two successive reflections is 200 kV, determine the amplitude of incoming surge. Look at the problem. Length of the line 500 kilometers, terminated resistance R 1000 ohms, line resistance 0.3 ohm per kilometer, surge impedance ZC 400 ohms, terminated voltage 200 kV, line resistance 500 kilometers. Therefore, the line resistance for 500 kilometers is 0.3 into line resistance is 0.3 per kilometer. For 500 kilometers, 0.3 into 500, that is 150 ohms per kilometer. Therefore, amplitude of incoming surge V is equal to 2R V dash by R plus ZC, 2 into 1000 into 200 into 10 cube divided by 1000 plus 150 plus 400. We are getting 258 kV. Another problem, a voltage having a crest value of 300 kV is traveling on a 750 kV line. The protection level is 700 kV and the surge impedance of the line is 300 ohms. Calculate first one, current in the line before reaching the arrestor. Second one, current through the arrestor. Value of the arrestor resistance for this condition. Fourth one, reflected voltage. Verify the reflection and refraction coefficient. ZC 300 ohms, V dash 300 kV, V 700 kV. Our first one, current V dash by ZC 3000 into 10 cube by 300, that is 10 power 4 amperes. Our voltage equations are 2 V dash minus ZIA plus VA. From that we are getting IA is equal to 6000 into 10 cube minus 1700 into 10 cube by 300. That is equal to 14333 amperes. Third one, resistance of the arrestor. R is equal to VA by IA, that is 1700 into 10 cube by 14333 is equal to 118.61 ohms. Fourth one, reflected voltage V minus V dash is plus V double dash. From that V dash is equal to minus 1300 kV. Now, reflection coefficients. Minus 1300 by 3000, that is equal to minus 0.433. Refraction coefficient 1700 by 3000, 0.567. Now reflection coefficient R minus Z by R plus Z, 2R by R plus Z, 118.61 minus 300 by 118.61 plus 300, that is equal to minus 0.433. Another one is 0.567. Like this. So refraction coefficient is 2R by R plus ZC, 2 into 118.61 divided by 118.61 plus 300, that is equal to 0.567.